Let's learn how to master the Spanish word que. In the first part of this video, I'm going to teach you how and when to use que. Then, you'll watch a fun story that demonstrates all the concepts that you've just learned. And finally, you'll watch the story again with English subtitles to check your comprehension. Let's get started! The word que is all over the place in Spanish. Without question or exclamation marks or an accent, with no question or exclamation marks but with an accent, and with question or exclamation marks and an accent. Que clearly has a lot of variation, so watch this whole video to find out the top uses of que. Let's start with que without an accent. Que can mean that when it's used as a conjunction, that is, to join two sentences into a single sentence. So, que can mean that, but not that as in an object you're pointing to, but a that is introducing a subordinate clause. That is to say, adding a part to a sentence that can stand alone or relies on the main part of the sentence to make sense. Here are some examples to help you understand this better. Es normal que estés cansada. It's normal that you're tired. Piensa que me gusta otra persona. He thinks that I like someone else. Me dijo que venía a casa. She told me that he is coming home. Nos dijeron que es una profesora. They told us that she is a teacher. Sé que viene a la fiesta. I know that she's coming to the party. Que, without question marks or an accent, is also the most common relative pronoun in everyday speech. This means que is used to connect sentences or give additional information. It can refer to people or things, in either singular or plural. When que is used as a relative pronoun, it can mean a number of things, like that, who, whom, and which. For instance, que as a relative pronoun can mean that, as in la comida que más me gusta, the food that I love the most. El coche que tengo es lento, the car that I have is slow. Son los libros que encargaste. They're the books that you ordered. El perro que ves allí es mío. The dog that you see over there is mine. Remember, while you can drop the relative pronoun in English and have the sentence still make sense, this is not the case in Spanish. You cannot drop que in any case since the sentence would not make any sense at all without it. Que, as a relative pronoun, can also mean who. Here are some more examples. El señor que vive ahí. The man who lives there. Soy Lucía, la chica que comparte el piso. I'm Lucía, the girl who's sharing this apartment. José, el chico del que te hablé, es muy guapo. José, the boy who I talked to you about, is very handsome. El chico que trabaja con nosotras, the boy who works with us. El hombre que vive ahí, the man who lives there. Que, as a relative pronoun, can also mean which. Some examples are la película que más me hizo reír, the movie which made me laugh the most. El libro que está en la mesa, the book which is on the table. El pantalón que está en la cama, the pants which are on the bed. La cocina que más me gusta es la española, the cuisine which I like the most is Spanish. Let's move on to que when used in comparisons to mean then. Es más alto que ella. He is taller than her. Soy más guapa que tú. I am prettier than you. Somos más listos que ellos. We are smarter than them. Eres más valiente que nadie. You are braver than anyone. Que, without question marks or an accent, commonly follows the word igual, meaning same or equal. When que follows igual, it's also used for comparisons, but it's equivalent to the English just instead of than. For example, eres igual que mi hermano. You are just like my brother. Es igual que su padre. He is just like his father. Soy igual que esa actriz. I am just like that actress. Eres igual que mi profesora. You are just like my teacher. Another common use of the word que without question marks or an accent is following the verb ser or to be. In this case, es que means the thing is. It's frequently used to give explanations, and although grammatically correct, it's seen as a bit informal. Some examples are es que no sé, The thing is, I don't know. Es que no he llegado todavía. The thing is, I'm not there yet. Es que creo que no. The thing is, I don't think so. Another use of que is to express commands with greater emphasis. In this case, there's no direct translation in English, but emphasizing the command. Here are some examples. Que dejes de hacer eso. Stop doing that. Que empiece la fiesta. Let's get this party started. Que te calles. Shut up. Que me dejes en paz. Leave me alone. The final use of the word que is followed by the subjunctive tense to express uncertainty, doubt, possibility, desire, obligation, or emotion. In this case, que translates to that as well and can be omitted in English. Here are some examples. Creo que tengo razón. I think that I'm right. Espero que todo salga bien. I hope that everything goes well. Tengo que ir al baño. I have to go to the bathroom. Puede que sea verdad. It might be true. Now, let's look at que, this time with an accent on the E. This que is used for two things. The first one is for impersonal expressions, like how plus adjective, what a, or such a. Here are some examples. Qué bonito, how beautiful. Qué fiesta, what a party. Qué desastre, such a disaster. Qué bien, how nice. Qué pena, what a pity. Qué buen tipo, such a nice guy. The other use of this type of que is in the middle of a sentence. Here are some more examples. No sé qué música me gusta. I don't know what music I like. No sé qué quiero. I don't know what I want. A trick for this one is when it sounds like you're answering a question. So, for no sé qué música me gusta, it would be ¿qué música te gusta? And for no sé qué quiero, it's ¿qué quieres? Our next type of que has question marks and an accent. This que is used to ask a question, a definition, or the uses of something. This que generally means what, and is followed by a verb or a noun. Let's look at some examples. ¿Qué día es hoy? What day is it today? ¿Qué hora es? What time is it? ¿De qué hablas? What are you talking about? ¿Qué ha dicho? What did she say? ¿Qué quieres hacer? What do you want to do? ¿Qué música te gusta? What music do you like? Or simply, ¿qué? What? But ¿qué? With an accent and with question marks doesn't always mean what. There's an exception when ¿qué? Is followed by the word tal. For example, ¿qué tal estás? How are you? Or ¿qué tal cocinas? How are you at cooking? The final type of que has exclamation marks and an accent on the E. Que. This que can also mean how or what if it's part of an exclamation or interjection. For example, qué decepción, how disappointing, what a disappointment. Qué guay, how cool. Qué emoción, how exciting. Qué fiesta más divertida, what a fun party. As you can see, the translation of how or what varies depending on what type of word follows que. If que is followed by an adjective or an emotion, then que means how. If que is followed by a noun, it means what, like in the last example. Que decepción is an exception. And finally, we have que when it translates to so. For example, qué rico está, it's so yummy. Qué guapo eres, you are so handsome. Qué lista es, she is so smart. We've now seen all the variations of the word que along with all its uses. So let's watch a fun story and see how much you've learned.
Tengo que irme ya.
No quiero que te vayas tan lejos.
Sé que no quieres, pero...
Pero sé que tienes que ir por trabajo.
Veo que el avión viene. Adiós.
¡Haz amigos!
¿Qué hora es?
Buenos días.
¿De qué hablas? Son las 4 de la mañana.
El jet lag. Hola, soy Lucía, la chica que comparte el piso.
Sí, encantada. Siento que ayer me dormí antes de que nos presentasen.
Es normal que estés cansada. Bienvenida.
José, el chico del que te hablé, es muy guapo.
¿José? ¿Qué?
Sí, José, que trabaja con nosotras.
Hola, Ana. ¿Qué tal estás?
Muy bien. José, que es tan guapo, me ha hablado.
¡Increíble! ¿Qué ha dicho?
¡Buenos días!
¿Qué?
Esta mañana, que he llegado tarde, me ha saludado. ¿Sabes que es el más guapo de la oficina?
¿Sabes que quién es el más guapo de la oficina?
¡Que Pepe es el más guapo!
¡Ah, qué pena! Pensaba que era yo.
¡Qué malentendido!
Piensa que me gusta otra persona. ¿Qué hago?
No tienes que preocuparte.
¿Por qué?
No hay ningún Pepe que trabaje en la oficina.
If you like this video, you love the upcoming beginner-friendly Fluent U course. It's going to have more engaging stories with helpful teacher explanations. It will be organized in a way that's more effective for learning and is perfect for beginners. It will contain exclusive content that you won't be able to find anywhere else and also integrate clips from movie scenes, TV shows, and more. You'll also get personalized quizzes and speaking questions to make it all stick. To try FluentU right now for free, click the link in the description below and start your free 2-week trial. FluentU is also currently having a sale, so now is the perfect time to check it out. In addition to this new course, the FluentU app also has thousands of authentic videos, including movie scenes, clips from TV shows, TED Talks, and music videos, all of which have interactive subtitles. Each word has a context-specific definition, with examples written by language experts, as well as video examples of native speakers using the vocab. Now watch the video again with English subtitles and see how much you understood.
Tengo que irme ya.
No quiero que te vayas tan lejos.
Sé que no quieres, pero...
Pero sé que tienes que ir por trabajo.
Veo que el avión viene. Adiós.
¡Haz amigos!
¿Qué hora es?
Buenos días.
¿De qué hablas? Son las 4 de la mañana.
El jet lag. Hola, soy Lucía, la chica que comparte el piso.
Sí, encantada. Siento que ayer me dormí antes de que nos presentasen.
Es normal que estés cansada. Bienvenida.
José, el chico del que te hablé, es muy guapo.
¿José? ¿Qué?
Sí, José, que trabaja con nosotras.
Hola, Ana. ¿Qué tal estás?
Muy bien. José, que es tan guapo, me ha hablado.
¡Increíble! ¿Qué ha dicho?
¡Buenos días!
¿Qué?
Esta mañana, que he llegado tarde, me ha saludado. ¿Sabes que es el más guapo de la oficina?
¿Sabes que quién es el más guapo de la oficina?
¡Que Pepe es el más guapo!
¡Ah, qué pena! Pensaba que era yo.
¡Qué malentendido!
Piensa que me gusta otra persona. ¿Qué hago?
No tienes que preocuparte.
¿Por qué?
No hay ningún Pepe que trabaje en la oficina.
In this next video, you'll learn all about the Spanish AR verbs with another fun story. Check it out.